Welcome back to Bloom. It's cold and flu season, and even if you've been vaccinated, you can still get the flu. Experts say now is the time to double down on our efforts to keep ourselves healthy. But how do we do that? Our next guest has what he says are the top five most effective immune supplements for cold and flu season. And James Laval joins us now. He is a clinical pharmacist and author of Cracking the Metabolic Code, as well as clinical director for the Pro Football Hall of Fame Performance Health Program. Welcome to Bloom, doctor.
It is great to be here. Thank you.
It's great to have you. I know last year a lot of people were buying up immune supplements. Now that there are vaccines for COVID and for the flu, do we still need to take these immune supplements?
Great question. I think the biggest issue is that even when people get vaccinated, they end up getting sick, right? I mean, we know that people get a flu vaccine, they still end up with at least a piece of the flu. And the reason you take nutrients are to keep your body in its best defense. So it's kind of another tool in your toolkit, if you want to think about your health, as looking at essential nutrients like vitamin D and C and zinc, and being able to utilize those to help bolster your immunity and to keep those essential nutrients in your body.
Doctor, what are the top five immune supplements that people are buying, and are they the right ones?
Yeah, I would say there's a variety of people out there reaching for things. DC, zinc, I already mentioned. Yeah, they're big. I'll tell you a couple other ones that I think are important. Aged garlic extract, actually. Not just garlic. I know people hear about garlic. Oh, I eat garlic. I don't need to go get aged garlic. When you age garlic, you change its composition. And it actually has been shown in human trials to reduce incidence, severity, and duration of cold and flu. The neat thing about that is that you can use that. There it is, chiolic. You can utilize that product year round because it has cardiovascular benefits as well. Helps to lower blood pressure. It's been shown to reverse vulnerable plaque. And most importantly, it reduces inflammation in your body. And those were the folks that got into trouble with, during the pandemic, was if they were pre-diabetic or diabetic or cardiovascular disease, it kind of had a smoldering fire in their body at baseline. And then of course, they would get an infection. And then that they would have more adverse outcomes because they already had those inflammatory compounds. Aged garlic really helps to reduce that. Otherwise, what you just showed, that bottle called chiolic. The other one, Moducare, plant sterols and sterolins. It acts as an immune modulator. It helps to keep your immune system in balance instead of running in overdrive. So those are two biggies. And I think there's other ones out there on the market, but those are two really good ones.
So that's an immune modulator versus an immune booster. How do you know the difference?
Yeah, that's a great question. So, when you think of immune boosters, you always hear about, oh, you got a cold or a flu coming on, go get some echinacea or golden seal or some other herb. Those are in the category of something that boosts your immune system. But it's not something that kind of is food for immune system and keeps your immune system in balance. For example, when you eat and you take Moducare as an immune modulator, it's from a concentrate from plants. So it's plant fats that was actually developed in South Africa for a low-cost way to help people that had HIV, which is obviously a viral issue. So the next thing that occurs is that you take it and it helps to keep that immune system almost like a teeter-totter, right? Keeping that immune system not from being too active, but not being too lazy. And I think for daily use, you want an immunomodulator.
Got it. I know that you work with a lot of athletes, doctor. Are there any extra steps that you recommend for people who are extra active?
Well, I think there's some key things. I mean, obviously, you've got to rest. I mean, what I always tell athletes is, it's not about how hard you work out in the gym. And this goes for people that are stopping off on the way home from work. It's how well you recover. And how well you recover is a factor of hydration, how nutrient dense is the food are you eating? Are you getting plenty of vegetables in? What's your stress response like? And in addition to that, are you getting a good night's sleep? We know that if you only get 5 hours of sleep a night, you're 9 times more likely to get a cold or flu versus if you get 7 to 9 hours sleep a night.
That is such a good tip. Thank you so much, doctor.
Yeah, my pleasure.
And if you'd like more information, visit Jim Laval, LAVALLE.com, or follow him on Twitter, Jim Laval. We'll be right back with more Bloom right after this.